Hi Virgo, welcome to your love and romance reading for February 2019. This is a general reading, so for further messages, please check your Venus, Moon and Rising sign videos. Don't forget to cross-watch your love and trust reading, and if you would like a private reading, all the information you need will be in the description link. So let's get into your reading. So we have romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. So there is someone you have very strong feelings for. Okay, and we have the King of Pentacles, and we have the Page of Raphael. So it says a new emotional situation, messages regarding relationships or social invitations, great intuitive insight. So for some of you, this could be someone new, it could be someone ongoing. But with the King of Pentacles, this is like a businessman. It's someone who is a hard worker. They try to create financial security. So yeah, they're very stable, they're very practical. And with the Page of Raphael, this could even signify that maybe it's a water sign, so maybe you're dealing with someone who's quite emotional. But either way, I feel like, you know, there's deep feelings between you and this person. Okay. Now, how you feel. So you've got the Page of Cups again, which is the same as the Page of Raphael. So you really are deep in your feelings about this person, okay? So we have very soon, clearly decide what you want, so it comes to you now. We do have the Three of Michael, which is the Three of Swords. So there is some pain regarding this person. So I don't know if they've done something to upset you. So you might be going through like a bit of heartbreak at the moment. So you do have feelings for this person. However, there's a bit of, there's like some heartache. There's some pain. Release the past. You will grow from this situation. Time heals all wounds. So there's definitely something that, you know, you need to heal from. Okay, now what you want is a soulmate. Okay, and I feel like with the Ace of Wands, you either want a renewed passion between you and an existing soulmate, or you want a new soulmate and you want to take charge, you want stability in this situation. So I feel like, you know, you want someone who's gonna, you know, give you that stability, okay, and maybe let you take the lead a little bit this time with the Emperor, because the Emperor is, you know, like a leader, an authoritative figure. So you either want someone who knows how to lead, or you want to lead the situation, okay? But either way, I feel like, you know, you do want a renewed passion, or passion with someone new, like a new soulmate, and you want stability. Now, how your love interest feels. You have chemistry. There's a strong magnetic attraction here. So this person really does have a strong attraction to you, okay? It's very magnetic. You know, it's more than just the average attraction. They are literally magnetically attracted to you. So there's something very appealing about you that kind of draws them in. Now we have the Knight of Raphael. So this person does want to come back and make an offer, you know, and they're saying topics that make your heart flutter. So this person does have very strong feelings for you, okay? And we've got the Five of Cups. So they have some regrets about things that maybe have happened. They are regretting the situation. They feel, you know, maybe they've lost you, and that, you know, they're kind of sulking about the situation. Okay, so the barriers. We have forgiven and learning. We have strength, and we have the Five of Pentacles. So something must have happened, because you're leaving this person out in the cold, and there's a lack of forgiveness here. So if you see the word forgiveness, they're speaking about forgiving. So I feel like either this person has not learned from their mistakes, which is why maybe you're not forgiving them and you're leaving them out in the cold. Or you're, you know, at this time, you're just not ready to forgive them, you know, and, you know, people always say that to forgive is like a good virtue, and yeah, it is, but you can't force forgiveness. If you're not ready to move past things that have happened, you know, you shouldn't be forced to forgive. So I'm not going to sit here and preach, you know, you have to forgive this person. You have to work on your pain, work on looking at what it is that's still hurt, you know, within you. if that makes sense, you know, before you can forgive. So, you know, again, there's definitely something that's happened, because we have the Three of Michael, which is about pain. Release the past, you will grow from this situation. Time heals all wounds. So there's definitely some wounds at the moment, and this could be why you're reluctant to forgive and why you're leaving this person out in the cold. So what your love and trust wants, true love, this is the romance of a lifetime. So they are being patient. They feel like they are investing wisely, and I feel like they're being patient with you to have this new start. So it's like they're making efforts. Like I said, they're investing wisely, which is they're making the effort, and they're hoping to have a new start, because they do see you as a true love, and they want a true love, and they feel like that's you, and that's why they're being patient, and they do want a new start with you, with the Ace of Pentacles. Okay, so the crowning energy is healing family issues. So whatever the situation is, it is healing. Okay, the situation is healing, and it's going to be worked on. But right now, with the Four of Swords, you're taking time out to heal. You know, again, I feel like it's all about healing for you in February. Because, you know, with the Three of Swords, which is the Three of Michael here, there is some deep pain. So you're kind of taking time out just to restore yourself. And, you know, you might be focusing on work, but I feel like, you know, you're working on healing, and you might heal the situation with this person. But I do feel as though there's a time out. So the outcome, so we do have a soulmate, okay? So I don't feel like you're going to be separated from this person for much longer, because we've got the Two of Raphael. So two hearts dedicated to creating something wonderful, kindred spirits, don't give up on those you love. So this is the soulmate card, the Two of Cups, even though it says Two of Raphael, this is the Two of Cups. So I feel like there's a sense of control here, okay? Because you've got let go of control issues, and then you've got the Ten of Wands. So it's like, I don't know if you're burdened. Maybe this person is kind of controlling. Maybe there's things... Yeah, so I feel like there's a guard as well, you know, because if you look at this woman, look how she's kind of guarding this child. So it's like when someone tries to control something, it's normally because they're scared of getting hurt. So this could be you, it could be the person you're dealing with. So yes, there's a mutual love, there's a mutual attraction between you both, there's soulmate energy. There's a need to put in the work, okay, with the Ten of Wands. So let's clarify the Ten of Wands. Why are you feeling burdened? Clarification on the Ten of Wands. The Hangman. Okay, so I feel like if it becomes too much of a burden, you're going to go back to taking a time out. Okay, you know, also if this person doesn't put in the hard work to repair what's happened between you and them, then, you know, you might choose to put things on pause again with the Hangman. Okay, and I feel... the way for you to heal the situation with this person is if you explain how you feel, and if they're open-minded and you get them to see things from your point of view. So, you know, you're going to have to be very, very open with this person, and vice versa. They're going to have to be open with you and allow you to understand how they see things, because the Hangman is all about seeing things from a different point of view. If you see he's upside down, when you're upside down, you can see things from a complete different point of view. So there is a need to, you know, work hard to understand each other's points of view. So what is the outcome in love for Virgo for February 2019? What is the outcome in love for Virgo for February 2019? Yeah, so someone is returning from the past, okay? Because this person is having memories of you, they're thinking a lot about you, okay? So someone is returning from the past, and you've got the Two of Raphael, which is the soulmate card. So a soulmate is returning. What is the outcome in love for Virgo for February 2019? Yeah, the Page of Pentacles. So some of you are going to receive an opportunity from this person, or you're going to give this person an opportunity, okay? What is the outcome in love for Virgo for February 2019? Yeah, so you... Yeah, so you are feeling a bit tied or trapped in this situation. So why is the Eight of Swords here? Okay. Because this person is so persistent, maybe that's what's making you feel a bit burdened with the Ten of Wands. Because this person, I feel like, is going to be very, very persistent with you. So, you know, you're kind of feeling trapped because, you know, they're really, really persistent. So this could be why, you know, they're kind of trying so hard and it's making you feel a little bit like, oh, you know, just let me breathe type of thing. And then this could be why the Hangman is there. So it's like if this person doesn't respect your space or respect your boundaries, they could find themselves put on pause again. So, okay, let's pull some oracle cards for you. What messages can you give me for Virgo for February 2019? Express your individuality. Allow your true self to shine because you're awesome. So you need to be your true authentic self, okay? Don't be afraid to be who you really are around this person, you know? What messages can you give me for Virgo for February 2019? Assertiveness. So, you know, you do need to be assertive. Stand up for your beliefs and only say yes if you really want to. So remember what I was saying about, you know, you feeling a bit trapped. If you do start to feel a bit stifled, assert yourself, you know. So don't be afraid to say, no, this is not what I want, or just, you know, let me have a bit of space right now. Assert yourself. Only say yes if you really want to. You know, if you don't want to go out on a date with this person, it's okay to say no. Only say yes if you really want to. What messages can you give me for Virgo for February 2019? And everything's okay. Don't worry, it's all working out in a beautiful way. So, you know, in terms of your life in general, everything is okay and it's all going to work out in a beautiful way. So I think that's a nice place to finish the reading. So I hope you guys enjoyed this reading. Again, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. And don't forget to comment what's going on in your love lives as well, because I do enjoy reading your comments. And yeah, if you would like a private reading, information will be in the description link. I hope you guys have a fantastic February and I will speak to you all soon. Bye, Virgo.